WOAD adaptation. This lab involves developing an adaptation circuit using microstrip lines based on the lab instructions. We use a section of open line, a T, and another section of 50 ohm line on a substrate from the Rogers Company RT Duroid 5880 Epsilon R2.2 to transform the 50 ohm load into the central frequency of 4 GHz. We first start a DS, create a workspace, and then create a schematic. After that, we start to draw the circuit based on the instructions of the course. We can now run the simulation, and we can see that the reflection coefficient is not the value that we need. To have the correct value of the reflection coefficient, we optimize the length of the microstrip lines using defined goals and optim component in the ADS environment. First, we need to add the optimization parameter by going to simulate simulation variable setup and checking two LTL1 and LTL2 parameters we defined in the VR component. Then we need to click on the optimization button. After optimization is done, we can see now that the value of the reflection coefficient is now correct. We then generate the layout by going to generate update layout. Then we add pins to the layout to be able to perform RF simulation on the layout. ADS does not propagate substrate parameters between schematic and layout windows. This can be considered a small oversight on the part of the software publisher. Therefore, we need to also define the substrate in the layout section. Now we can perform an RF simulation of the layout. As we can see, the result of S11 is different from that obtained by the schematic window. This is because a DS cannot resolve the problem accurately when the port is too close to a discontinuity. To get around this problem and get closer to real results, we add a piece of 50 ohm line, 1 or 2 millimeter, between the T and port 2 in the schematic, then generate the layout again, then replace ports 1 and 2, and finally restart the simulation. We will see that the results are closer to the desired values and are more accurate. But can we do better? For this purpose, we will optimize the lengths of lines L1 and L2 in the layout window by defining the layout as an EM model and introducing it into the schematic and performing the optimization. By doing this, we can obtain more accurate lengths for the microstrip lines in the layout.